Hi, Mac.
Hey, Alicia.
I'm on the spot here to say something wise, and I don't know if I'll be able to come up with that or not without choking up. And the main thing I want to tell both of you is that Mom and I are with you all the way, all the time. We're only a phone call away from wherever you are. We both love you very much. We're so happy to be here today. And so please stay in touch with us, and we're going to do the same with you as long as it takes. Bye-bye.
Look at you. That's pretty.
This is so nice.
This is a wonderful day. This is the first day of the rest of your lives together. You know, Alicia, Mac, how much Deb and I, Al and Connie, love you both. You know how much Boom. How much we're there and will always be there to support you. This is a beautiful day. When you are old and gray and you are looking back through tired eyes that might be gray, you won't be thinking about how old and tired you are. You'll be thinking about today. I'll be saying this at some point. There is no Romeo or Juliet that has ever been, that is now, or ever will be, that will be as lovely and together as each of you are with one another. We love you. We know you're going to have a wonderful life together. We'll always be there to support you.
Thank you.
God is love, and those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. You may be seated. Today we gather in the presence of God to give thanks for the gift of marriage, to witness the joining together of Mac and Alicia, to surround them with our prayers and to ask God's blessing upon them so that they may be strengthened for their life together and nurtured in their love for God. God created us male and female and gave us marriage so that a husband and wife may help and comfort each other, living faithfully together in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, throughout all their days. God gave us marriage for the full expression of the love between a man and a woman. In marriage, a man and a woman belong to each other, and with affection and tenderness, freely give themselves to each other. God gave us marriage for the well-being of human society, for the ordering of family life, and for the birth and nurture of children. God gave us marriage as a holy mystery in which a man and a woman are joined together and become one, just as Christ is one with the church. In marriage, husband and wife are called to a new way of life, created, ordered, and blessed by God. This way of life must not be entered into carelessly, or from selfish motives, but responsibly and prayerfully. We rejoice that marriage is given by God, blessed by the Lord Jesus Christ, and sustained by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, let marriage be held in honor by all. Let us pray. Gracious God, you are always faithful in your love for us. Look mercifully upon Alicia and Mac, who have come seeking your blessing. Let your Holy Spirit rest upon them, so that with steadfast love, they may honor the promises they make this day. In our Savior's name, amen. Mac and Alicia, understanding that God has created, ordered, and blessed the covenant of marriage, do you affirm your desire and intention to enter into this covenant? Do you?
I do.
Al and Connie, Randy and Debbie, do you give your blessings to Alicia and Mac, and promise to do everything in your power to uphold them in their marriage? Do you?
I do.
And to all of you witnessing these vows, will you promise to do everything in your power to uphold Alicia and Mac in their marriage? And if so, would you answer, we do.
Thank you.
Tomorrow morning if you wake up and the sun does not appear, I will be here. If in the dark we lose sight of love, hold my hand and have no fear, 'cause I will be here. And I will be here when you feel like being quiet, when you need to speak your mind, I will listen. And I will be here to watch you grow
Let us pray. Open our ears, our minds, and our hearts to hear and be formed by your words, O God. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth into joyous song and sing praises. Sing praises to the Lord with the lyre and the sound of melody, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Make a joyful noise before the King, the Lord. Let the sea roar and all that fills it, the world and those who dwell in it. Let the floods clap their hands. Let the hills sing for joy together before the Lord, for he comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with equity.
I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love. I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends, and for prophecies, they will pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For our knowledge is imperfect, and our prophecy is imperfect. But when the perfect comes, the imperfect will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I gave up childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall understand fully, even as I have been fully understood. So faith, hope, and love abide, these three. But the greatest of these is love.
This passage we just heard from Corinthians is a favorite reading for weddings, and for good reason, because it lays out so beautifully that love is the most basic, most essential ingredient for life together. It's the highest of all the spiritual gifts. This passage is not actually addressed to a couple about to be married, but is written to a church in Corinth, which was struggling to figure out how to be a church. But these words of Scripture speak to us whatever our circumstance, for they hold the secret to abundant life and give us a question to measure by which to measure all our actions. Are they loving? Are we acting out of love? Your dad, Mac, spoke so beautifully last night about the acorns he planted that rooted and grew so close together that he dared not separate them. So he moved them together and planted them wherever they lived. And as they grew together, forming one beautiful tree. I want to talk about trees, too, because it seems so appropriate as we stand here today surrounded by such magnificent ones. You wonder about all they have seen and all the storms they have withstood. We see evidence of those storms, broken and missing branches, yet they have not diminished their beauty or their ability to provide shade, shelter for the birds and animals, clean air for us, and sheer beauty. Their scars speak to their ability to endure, to have grown roots so deep that they have supported the trees during the worst of happenings. They know where their source of life is, and they lift their branches and their leaves to the sun and send their roots deep searching for water. But getting to this grandeur didn't happen overnight. About 5 years ago, I got some of the seedlings from the Forest Service that were rooted from the Peace Swamp Chestnut Oak, which is also a magnificent tree. The first years, they had to be tended so carefully. The one planted in the woods flourished and is more than twice the size of the others that had to struggle with that coastal Bermuda grass that wants to choke it out. One in particular I didn't think was going to make it. Even in the third year, it had one leaf and was about an inch high. But I kept watering it and caring for it. And in the dark of the earth, its roots kept growing, searching for life-giving nutrients. And finally, the next year, it began to grow. Now it is one of the strongest and the biggest in the field. I'm so thankful I didn't give up on it. Those seedlings remind me also that we mature at different speeds and that we need to be patient with each other. A marriage is like those seedlings. In order for it to flourish, it needs care, careful tending and feeding. It needs lots of love in the form of patience and kindness. It needs love in the form of attentive listening, of time together to play and just be together. It needs you to believe in each other and encourage each other to grow and develop your gifts and know when to put each other's needs before your own. And give each other the space and support you need to grow into the people God has created you to be. All these things take practice, and that practice is made easier when you add in gratitude. When you begin each day looking for things to be thankful for in each other and in the world around you, look for the beauty. It's there. Some days, like today, it's easy and the gratitude flows. Some days aren't so easy. But looking for things to be thankful for may be about the last thing you feel like doing. That's when you fall back on your will and remember the promises that you're making today. And you consciously choose to be thankful. God honors these choices and gives you the strength to look and to see. And when you begin looking for things to give thanks for, you find them. A supportive community is also so important for a thriving marriage. And I rejoice with you that you have so many who love you and want only the best for you. Let them help you. Enjoy them. And be there for them as well. I've loved spending time with you, hearing your stories, and seeing your obvious love for each other. Your happiness makes us all happy. Nurture each other and that love, and you will find your marriage strong and fruitful like these trees, capable of providing you shelter in the worst of storms and shade in the hottest of days. Together, with God's help, you will create for each other a place of safety and comfort and joy. May God bless you richly. Amen. Mac and Alicia, since it is your intention to marry, would you join hands and with your promises, bind yourselves to each other as husband and wife? Mac, I Mac, take you Alicia to be my wife.
I, Mac, take you Alicia to be my wife.
And I promise before God and these witnesses.
And I promise before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Alicia. I, Alicia, take you, Mac, to be my husband.
I, Alicia, take you, Mac, to be my husband.
And I promise before God and these witnesses.
And I promise before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
And plenty and in want.
And plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I'm going to put it on her finger and repeat after me. This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
As a sign of our constant faith and abiding love.
As a sign of our constant faith and abiding love.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
As a sign of our constant faith and abiding love.
As a sign of our constant faith and abiding love.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let us pray. Eternal God, without your grace, no promise is sure. Strengthen Mac and Alicia with patience, kindness, gentleness, and all other gifts of your Spirit, so that they may fulfill the vows they have made. Keep them faithful to each other and to you. Fill them with such love and joy that they may build a home of peace and welcome. Guide them by your word to serve you all their days. Help us all, O God, to do your will in each of our homes and lives. Enrich us with your grace so that supporting one another, we may serve those in need and hasten the coming of peace, love, and justice on earth. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. And now let us all join together in the prayer Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Before God and in the presence of this congregation, Mac and Alicia have made their solemn vows to each other. They have confirmed their promises by the joining of hands and the giving of rings. Therefore, I now proclaim that they are a husband and wife. Blessed be the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. And those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. As God's own, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, and patience, forgiving each other as the Lord has forgiven you, and crown all these things with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord be kind and gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Mac, you may kiss the bride. Oh. And now I would like to present to all of you Mr. and Mrs. Clark.